Hello friends, I am BJ Dave, lecturer in English, working at Government Polytechnic Junagadh. Dear friends, the subject English has been offered to the students of diploma in first semester engineering students of Gujarat Technological University. In this particular lecture, I am going to deal with determiners. This topic I will be dealing in two parts. What are determiners, different kinds of determiners, their uses, and in the second part we will be dealing with some exercises. So at the end of these two lectures, you will be able to define determiners, enlist determiners, how many determiners are actually there in English. Thereafter, you will be able to know the uses of different determiners. You will also understand the difference between given pairs of determiners. For example, you will be able to understand the difference between the uses of article A and N, or article A or and, and the indefinite articles and definite articles. Moreover, you will be able to use a correct determiner in a given sentence. First of all, we will know what do we mean by determiners. A determiner is a word that usually comes before a noun and determines or specifies the meaning of that noun. As the word itself suggests, the name itself suggests, determiner means it determines something. To put it very simply, it decides something. What does it decide? It decides the meaning of a noun which comes before it. So in that way we call them determiners. Now we will have some examples of determiners. The best book, here the word the is a determiner, because as per the definition given above, it specifies a particular book. Which book you are talking about? I am talking about the best book written by Chetan Bhagat, for example. Next, his friend. Whose friend you are talking about? When we use this particular word his before the noun friend, we determine about which friend you are talking. Next, that man. Which man you are talking about? I am talking about that man. That man, for example, standing over there. That man, for example, standing under the tree. That man, for example, who is talking on his mobile phone. So this particular word, that, it points out which man somebody is talking about, and in this way it is a determiner. It determines the status of man. Next, every teacher. Which teacher you are talking about? I'm talking about every teacher. So this particular word, which I have put in bold and also I have underlined, it is a determiner, because it specifies which teacher is being talked about. So in all these examples which I have given, the words that has been written in bold or the words that has been underlined, they are said to be determiners. The, his, that, every, all these words in these phrases, they are known as determiners, because again they determine the meaning of a noun before which they are used. They determines or specifies their meaning. Another example, some cars. About which cars you are talking about? I'm talking about some cars. So this particular word some, it specifies the number of cars that a person is referring to. Some cars are very costly. Some cars are very luxurious. So in these two examples, the word sum is a determiner. It determines the meaning of the word cars. I think, friends, now you understand what do we mean by determiners as we have defined them, and from the examples you can I hope that you have understood what is meant by them. In the next slide, we are going to list determiners. First of all, articles A and the. Though we popularly know them or call them articles, basically in grammar they are known as determiners. Demonstratives like this, that, these, those, all of them are determiners. This boy, that girl, these computers, those cameras. In these examples, all these words, this, that, these and those, they are determiners. Possessives like my, our, your, his, her, their, etc. They are also known as determiners. To be very specific, we call them possessives because they show possession. Whose book? My book. Whose car is it? It is our car. Whose camera is it? It is your camera. Whose lecture it is? It is his lecture. Whose turn it is? It is her turn. So these are again determiners. Next, distributives. The words each, every, either, neither, they also come under the category of determiners. Specifically, we have given the name distributives to them because they suggest distribution. Each student, every student, either teacher, neither students. So in these examples, each, every, either and neither, they are determiners. Next, quantifiers. Quantifiers like some, any, all, no, much, many, etc. They are also said to be determiners. Why do we say them quantifiers here? Because they show quantity. Of course, they do the work of a determiner. They determine the meaning of a noun before which they come. But additionally, they show quantity of something. Some boys, some apples, etc. Any apple. To be more specific, did you buy any apples today? So any here is a determiner. All lectures were very good. Here the word all is a determiner. No, I don't want it. No, I don't have any book. This particular word no is a determiner, which shows quantity. Much, how much time will it take to finish the assignment? So the word much is a determiner. Many, how many students were present in the last lecture? The word many shows quantity and does the work of a determiner. So generally we call all these items that you show that you see in this particular slide as determiners. Further, interrogative words like whose, what, which, etc. They are also determiners. Which pen? Which boy? Which student were you talking about? The word which comes here before the word student. Student is a noun, and which determines its meaning. That's why all these words, they are known as determiners, and they are also known as interrogatives because they ask about the status of somebody or something. Now friends, one by one we will discuss the determiners that we have seen in the last slide. First of all, we are going to discuss articles. Let us know about the types of articles. First of all, in English, there are two articles. Specifically, they are A or N. A or N is called the indefinite article because it refers to an indefinite person or thing before which it is used. Here the word indefinite is important. Indefinite, in other words, uncertain. Article A or N is used before a noun which is uncertain, about which we are not much certain, about which we do not know much thing. For example, call a boy. Which boy? Any boy. I say any boy. I am not very certain. Call a pune. Which pune should I call? Should I call a pune from the civil department? Should I call a pune from mechanical department? No, I am not specifying. You can call any pune. A pune means any pune. So in this way, these two articles, they are known as indefinite articles. Here, as we have seen in the example of any pune, the meaning of A or N is any. Any means uncertain. Any means indefinite. Any program, any computer, a computer means any computer. Can I have a computer? Can I have any computer? Can I have a pen? Any pen, etc. Here you can see the example on the slide. Call a doctor. Which doctor you are talking about? Call a doctor means call any doctor. I am not saying that you call my family doctor. You call a doctor who is MD in physician. Any doctor will do. Call a doctor means any doctor. Article A or N is known as indefinite article. Next, article the. The is called the definite article because it points out some particular person or thing. Here the word definite is important because when you use the word the before any noun, it specifies it. It makes it certain, unlike A or N. Here the meaning of the is ascertain or a particular person or thing. For example, when I say call the doctor, here the doctor means a specific doctor. For example, my family doctor, call the doctor. Should I call any doctor? No, I am talking about a particular doctor. I am talking about my family doctor. That is what I mean when I say call the doctor. Next, it also comes to our mind when we are talking about article, which are one kind of determiners. We should also know when should at which place should we put them. What should be the position of an article in a given sentence? Generally, an article is used before a noun. In a sentence, we use article before a noun. A boy. Boy is a noun. We will put article a before them. The doctor. We will put article the before doctor, which is a noun. Further, if an adjective comes before a noun, the article is placed before the adjective. My friends, you should have some knowledge of adjective. What is an adjective? Adjective is a word which adds to the meaning of a noun. So when adjective is there, and adjectives, they are generally used before noun. So the question comes, where should we put the article? So the answer is, when both noun and adjectives are present in a given sentence, we should use article the before the. We should use any article, either A or N or the, before adjective and not before a noun. Here you can see the examples in a slide. A room. Room is a noun. We have put the article a before the noun. In another example, you can see a spacious room. The word room is a noun, but the word spacious is adjective. What kind of room or what type of room? It's a spacious room. So spacious is an adjective of the word room. So when adjective is present before a noun, we should put article or before adjective. Next example, the house. House is a noun. We have put the word, we have put the article the before noun. The beautiful house. What kind of house or what type of house? Beautiful house. House is a noun. Beautiful is adjective. The beautiful, the comes before the word adjective, which is beautiful. So I'm sure you can now understand when should where should we put the article or what should be the position of an article. In the next slide, we are going to learn about different about the use of the indefinite article. When should we use the article A or when should we use the article N? So in order to understand the use of article A or N in a sentence, we should have a knowledge where in which circumstances we should use them. So the choice between A or N depends on the initial sound of a word and not its spelling. Remember friends, I say again, I re-emphasize, we have to take care of sound of a word and not its spelling. And I say initial or beginning sound of a particular word is taken care of, is taken into consideration while choosing between the article A or N. Therefore, to use article A or N correctly, it is necessary to understand the difference between consonant and vowel sounds. In the slide that you are watching now, in the first sentence I have written initial sound. So we should have a knowledge of sounds, particularly to understand whether to use article A or N. So what kinds of sounds are there? So there are two kinds of sounds: consonant sounds and vowel sounds. When the word begins with a vowel sound, we should use article N before that. When the initial sound of a word is a consonant, we should use article A before it. So here we should understand the difference between consonant and vowel sounds. Now let us understand vowels. Vowels are voiced sounds made with the mouth open. I repeat, vowels are voiced sounds made with the mouth open. Here you can see the example. Again, remember my friends, you have to take care of the sound of a word and not its spelling. Here the sound A, A, I. These sounds are vowel sounds. These sounds are made with the mouth open. E, E sound or I sound. These are vowel sounds again. The sound I, E or I, again they are vowel sounds. Sound O, A or AU, again vowel sounds made with the mouth open. And the sound U, U sound is also a vowel sound, not U or Y, but the sound U sound or A sound. For example, in umbrella, the spelling of umbrella is U-M-B-R-E-L-L-A. But as we have said earlier, we do not have to take care of the spelling of a word, but we have to take care of its sound. The initial sound of umbrella is A, and that's why it's a vowel sound. And before a word beginning with a vowel sound, we will make use of article N. Now let us understand consonants or consonant sounds. What do we mean by them? Consonants are sounds blocked by the tongue, teeth, or lips They can be voiced or unvoiced. Remember, friends, vowel sounds are made with the mouth open, whereas consonant sounds are blocked by the tongue, teeth or lips. Examples of consonant sounds are b, m, f, r, k, etc. All these sounds that I have just spoken, these are sounds, they are blocked either by the tongue, teeth or lips, and that's why they are known as consonants. There is one consonant which is pronounced with the mouth open and no blockage, but it is unvoiced, the H sound. The examples of these this H sound is honest. The word begins with H-O-N-E-S-T, but we pronounce it as honest. Here the word H remains silent. So we will go, or we will follow the sound and not its spelling. As the pronunciation is honest, as the initial sound is O, which is a vowel sound, we will put article N before honest. An honest man, an honest worker, an honorable person. All these sounds are again vowel sound. Again, see the word H-E-I-R. Here, the pronunciation is air and not hair. Had the pronunciation been hair, then we will put article A before it. But the pronunciation is air and not hair. H remains silent over here. And that's why again, before H-E-I-R, air, we will put article N before it. To make it very clear, let me give you some examples of the use of article A or N. A or N is used before singular countable nouns. Again, let me repeat, the article A or N is used before singular countable nouns. It is never used before plural nouns. For example, a table. A table means one table. Again, table, T sound is a consonant sound, and that's why we will put article A before it. An apple. Apple is a singular noun, and that's why we have chosen article N before it. And out of or N, we have chosen article N, because in the word apple, the initial sound is A, and A sound is a vowel sound, and that's why article N. Next, a paper. Paper is a singular noun. It's a countable noun. One paper, two paper, you can count. And the initial sound of paper is pa. Pa sound is consonant sound, and that's why article A. A pen. Again, pen, singular countable noun. You can count the pens. Here, pen, it doesn't have S or ES suffix in the end, and that's why it's a singular noun, countable noun. And before it, we put article A because it's a consonant sound. Next, A or N is never used before a plural noun or an uncountable noun. For example, it is incorrect to say a computers, because the original meaning of article A or N is one. It is incorrect to say a computers, because computers is a plural noun and we never use article A or N before it. Further, N tractors or a tractors. It is wrong to say a tractors, because tractors is a plural noun. A milk. Milk is an uncountable noun. It cannot be counted, and that's why it is incorrect to say a milk. Now let us see the example of article N. First of all, let us make it clear, when should we make use of article N? Article an is used in the following cases. Before words beginning with an open vowel which is sounded as open. Let me repeat. Article an is used before words beginning with an open vowel which is sounded as open. So again, take care of the sound and not the spelling of a word to decide which article to use, article a or an. See the examples for your clarity. An almond, the word almond, singular, countable noun, begins with vowel sound, a sound, vowel sound, made with the mouth of an, that's why article an. An enemy, enemy, a sound, vowel sound, article n. An ink pad, here the initial sound of the word is e. The sound e is pronounced with the mouth of an, and that's why article n. An iPod, initial sound is a, iPod, a is a vowel sound, and that's why article n. An umbrella, the initial sound of the word umbrella is a, vowel sound, made with the mouth open, and that's why article n. Next example, object, word object, begins with o sound, o sound, vowel sound, made with the mouth open, that's why article n. In the next example, university is there. Generally it is believed that when a word begins either with a or e or I or o or u, we have to put article n before it, but it is wrong. Again and again I have said you that we don't have to see the spelling of a word, we have to see its initial sound. In the word university or university, the sound is y, and y sound is not a vowel sound, it's a consonant sound, u, u sound, consonant sound, and that's why article a. A European, though the word begins with e, we have to see the sound of European is u, u sound is a consonant sound, and that's why article e, that's why article a. Next, a one-man show, again, one-man show, the word begins with O, but look at its sound. The sound is V and not O, and that's why article A will be there, because V is a consonant and not a vowel, and that's why article A will be put over there. See the further uses of article N and its examples. Article N is also used before words beginning with a silent or aspirated H. Example, to make the thing more clear, an or, H-O-U-R. Here the word or, in the word or, H remains silent. We pronounce it as or, and a sound is a vowel sound, and that's why article N will be there before the word or. Next, an honorable person, honorable person, o, o sound, it's a vowel sound, and that's why article n. Article n is used before consonants which are pronounced with the sound of an open vowel. Here the word MPhil is there, but if you look at its sound, it is an open vowel, though it looks like a consonant, but it is an open vowel, a sound, MPhil, a sound, and that's why article n. FRCS, see the sound, a sound of FRCS, it's an open vowel, and that's why article n. NSP, SP, a sound, open vowel, and article n will be there. Here are examples of article a. A banana, ba sound, consonant sound, that's why article a uniform, ya sound, consonant sound, article a woman, va sound, consonant sound, article a house, ha sound, consonant sound, article a union, ya sound, consonant sound, article a 1 rupee not, 1 rupee not. See the sound, wa and not o, wa sound, consonant sound, article a. In a hurry, we often make use of this expression, I am in a hurry. So hurry, ha sound, consonant sound, article a headache, again headache begins with consonant sound, ha sound, consonant sound, article a. Here, let me make it clear, the uses of article a or an, or rather, what do we mean by a or an when we use them in different sentences. Usually, article a or an is used to mean any or one. The original meaning, as I have said you earlier, of a or an is one. Another meaning of article a or an is any. See the example. A child should obey his parent. Which child you are talking about? A child means I am talking about any child. It is applicable to any child. A child, any child. Call a student. A student means any student. Maybe a student of mechanical engineering, maybe a student of first semester, maybe a student of last semester. Call a student, call any student. 100 meters make a kilometer. Here the meaning of a is one. In another words, we can say 100 meters make 1 kilometer. A kilometer means 1 kilometer. Give me a pen and a paper. Give me one pen and one paper. Here the meaning of a is one. Again, this means that a or an is used only before a singular noun because of its meaning, and its meaning, as we know it very well, is one. That's why it can never be used before plural nouns or uncountable nouns. Further uses of article a or an. A or an is used in expressions involving a quantity, price, speed, etc. For example, a few doctors. We often say a few doctors. We often say a lot of apps. A lot of apps are available. 100 kilometers an hour. So it shows speed of a car or a bus. 100 kilometers an hour. Now we have seen the uses of article a or an in detail. Now let us go to the uses of article the. The is used before both singular and plural nouns as well as uncountable nouns. Here mark it very clearly, unlike a or an, article the can be used with both singular and plural nouns as well as uncountable nouns, means those nouns which cannot be counted. Examples: the cooling fan. Fan you can count, it's a singular word, we can use article the before it. The monitors. Monitor, countable noun, it is here in plural form, we can use article the before it. The oil. Oil is an uncountable noun, we can use article the before it. The is also used before a particular person or thing, or the person or thing already referred to. This is the most widely used example of article the. Let me repeat, article the is also used before a particular person or thing or the person or thing already referred to. From the example, it will be very clear what do I mean by particular person or thing. See the example. The girl in white is very sincere. Somebody may ask me which girl you are talking about. So I specify. I make the girl particular. The girl in white. The description of a girl comes after the noun. So I am making it very particular, very specific. So many girls, for example, are standing under the tree. But there is only one girl who is dressing in white. So about that particular girl, I can point out to that particular girl. The girl in white is very sincere. Particular girl. The bus by which I came was late by half an hour. Which bus you are talking about? See in the example, the bus by which I came, the particular bus in which I have made my journey. I am talking about that particular bus. It was late by half an hour. Particular person or thing. Another example, I bought a pen. The pen cost me rupees 50. I bought a pen. Look at the use of the word pen in first sentence. In the second sentence, we are repeating the word pen. The pen which I have used in the first sentence, about the same pen I am talking about. I am talking about its cost. So when a particular word is repeated in our talk or in written English again and again, the repeated words, they take the article the before them. Again, talking about the uses of article the is used when it is clear from the situation which people or things we refer to. Let me repeat. It is used when it is clear from the situation which people or things we refer to. May I use the computer? Maybe when asking about the use of computer, I am looking at a particular computer. Or maybe there is only one computer, for example, in a lab, and I am talking about that particular computer. So it is very clear to the audience which computer I am talking. So article the before it. The director is holding a meeting with the principal. Which director you are talking about? Our director. For example, the director of a college. So everybody knows the director, and that's why article the director is holding a meeting with the principals. Principals, for example, all principals of different colleges under a university. So the principals. The watchman has come. For example, the watchman come to a house in a residential society. Everybody knows who is the watchman. So it is very clear which watchman I am talking about, and that's why article the will be used before it. Switch on the pen. For example, I am sitting on a chair directly under the fan. So it is quite clear from the circumstances that I am talking about a particular fan under which I am sitting, and that's why it is clear, and that's why we use article the before it, the fan. Next use of article the, it is used before a common noun that represents the whole class. Article the is used before a common noun that represents the whole class. My friends, you will be knowing what do we mean by a common noun. For example, Ramesh is a proper noun. Mahesh, proper noun. Jitesh, it's a proper noun. But when we say student, when we identify all these persons, Ramesh or Mahesh or Jitesh, when we make use of a common noun to identify all of them in a group, we make use of the word student or boy. So these words, student or boy, they are known as common nouns. So here, before a common noun that represents the whole class, The dog is a faithful animal. Which dog you are talking about? I am talking about all dogs. The whole class of dogs. The peacock is a beautiful bird. The peacock means all peacocks. They are beautiful. Next use of article the. The is also used with the following names. It is used before the names of gulfs. As you can see, the Persian Gulf, the Bay of Bengal. It is used before the names of rivers, the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Thames, the Seine, etc. Before the names of rivers. Article the is also used before the names of seas and oceans. Sea, the Red Sea. Ocean, the Indian Ocean. Article the. It is also used before the names of islands. For example, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the Lakshadweep Islands, the British Isles, names of islands. Article the is used also before the names of mountain ranges, the Alps, the Vindhyas. Also, article the is used before the names of desert, the Sahara Desert, the Kutch Run. Article the is also used before the names of sacred books, Gita, the Gita, sacred book for the Hindus, the Bible, the Bible. It's a sacred book for the Christians, the Bible. Also, we make use of article the before great works of literature, Iliad and Odyssey. These are the great epics written by Greek poet Homer. And that's why we put article the before them, the Iliad, the Odyssey. It is also used before the names of trains and ships. Here are the examples of trains, the Rajdhani Express, the British Airways, names of flights, aeroplanes. The article the is also used before famous buildings, the Golden Temple, situated in Amritsar, the Qutub Minar. Before the names of certain countries, we also make use of article the, particularly the countries before which we use article the has been listed over here, the USA or the United States of America, the UK or the United Kingdom, the Netherlands. Particularly, the rule is that when in the name of a country, when there is one common noun, we generally put article the before it. In the given example, there is one common noun. For example, in the word USA, states is a common noun, and that's why we put article the before it. Otherwise, before the names of other countries like India, we do not make use of any article. We do not say the India, we do not say the Germany, we do not say the France. Further, article the is also used before the names of whole families, the Tatas, the Birlas, the Khan. The is also used before the names of nationalities. We don't say the India, but we do say the Indian. We don't say the Germany, but we do say the German, the French, the Italian, the Gujarati, etc. The is also used before the names of newspapers, the Times of India, the Hindu, the Sandesh, the Divya Bhaskar, etc. Further, article the is also used before the names of musical instruments, the flute, the guitar, the sitar, the piano, etc. Further, article the, as we have said earlier, it is also used before the names of ships, the Ashoka, the Titanic, the Vikrant. Let us see further uses of article the. The is also used before common nouns which are unique. Let me repeat, common nouns which are unique, which are only one in the world. The sun, the moon, the stars, the earth, the sea, the ocean, the sky, the equator, the north, the east. The name before the names of directions, we also use article the. The is also used before superlatives. Superlatives, my friends, you might be knowing, there are adjectives and there are degrees of adjectives. For example, to some student we say that he is a tall student. He is taller than her. So the word taller is more powerful than the word tall. Adjective tall is more adjective taller is more powerful than the word tall. And if we want to show the highest degree of something, we use superlative degree, which generally ends with the suffix st or est. So in the examples given below, the word best, most or darkest, they are superlatives. The word the best, the most important, the darkest, before all these superlatives, we make use of article the. The is also used before ordinals. The first, the second, the next, the last, etc. What do we mean by ordinals? Ordinals are words which show order of something. The first chapter, the first bench, the first lecture, the second cricket match. It shows order of something, and that's why it is known as ordinals. And before them, we put article the. The is also used with comparatives. In the example given below, the word sooner and better, these are comparatives. Sooner, better, and before them we make use of article the. The sooner you reach, the better. When should I reach the place? The sooner the better, we say. We also say, go to the cinema. Let us go to the cinema. Let us go to the theater. For example, we are listening to the radio. We say, listen to the radio. What you are doing? I am listening to the radio. What you are doing? I am surfing the internet. So before the word internet, we also use article the. What you are doing? I am watching television. Before television, we don't use any article. The is also used before an adjective when the noun is understood. Let me repeat. It is used before an adjective when the noun is understood. See the example given below. We should help the needy. Here from the example, it looks that the word needy is an adjective. Before, but in this particular sentence, it has been used as a noun. The needy means the needy people. That's why article the will be put before it. Blessed are the ignorant. Here the word ignorant has been used as a noun. Blessed are the ignorant. The is used in certain fixed idiomatic phrases also. Like in the wrong. You are in the wrong. We often say on the contrary. We often say on the contrary. We often say up to the mark. His performance was up to the mark. Let us also learn, friends, when should we repeat the article, or what do we mean when we repeat the article? To understand this particular thing, look at the example given below. I have a white and a black cat. Here I have repeated the article a before white and before black. So when I repeat article a, what do I mean? I mean that there are two cats, one white and one black. Do you remember, friends? In the earlier slide, we said that the original meaning of article a is one. So here one white and one black. So if there are more than two nouns being indicated in a sentence, the article is repeated before each noun or each adjective. Second example, I have a white and black cat. Here the word or article a is used only once, before the first adjective. So what do we mean? It means that there is only one cat, but its color is partly white and partly black. So if there is only one noun, the article is used before the first adjective only. Look at the other examples. The clerk and the typist were out of station. Here, article the has been used before the word clerk and the word typist. What do we mean? We mean that there are two persons. The post of clerk is being held by some person, by Mr. X, and the post of typist is being held by another person, Mr. Y. Two persons. Another example, the clerk and typist was out of station. Here the article the has been used before the first noun only. It means that only one person is doing both clerical and typing verb. There is only one person, and that's why article the is used before the first noun only. My friends, till now we have seen the uses of different articles, article a, article an, and article the. We have also seen when the article is being repeated, what do we actually mean. In the second part of the lecture, in which I am going to complete this particular topic, I am going to talk about the omission of articles, and finally I'll be dealing with remaining determiners, which are some, any, much, many, etc. Thank you, friends.